Welcome to this YouTube channel. In this video we are going to talk about the top 10 golf courses in New York. Before starting this video, like this video and subscribe to our channel for future updates. The state of New York, with the Big Apple at its center, needs no introduction. Everyone is familiar with the shopping, Broadway, and a slew of other world-famous attractions in and around the United States' most populous metropolis. As a result, some golfers may be startled to learn that the New York metropolitan area has more world-class golf courses than any other city. The following are the top 10 golf courses in New York City. Number 10. Garden City Golf Club. Garden City GC is one of the great early tournament sites in the United States. With a minimalist design, you can still see faint remains of ancient roadbeds over which the course was routed, and natural upkeep. Cree built the course into what it is today before the 1908 U.S. Amateur, with several deep pot bunkers dictating strategy. Travis put them up to encourage thinking golf, but one player quickly called Garden City the birthplace of the God-fearing approach shot. It's also a one-of-a-kind 100 greatest course with a par 3 finish. The Island Golf Links, a 9-hole layout for guests of the Garden City Hotel, first opened on May 29, 1897. It was quickly expanded to 18 holes with a total length of almost 6,000 yards, 5,500 meters, making it the longest course in the United States. It was designed by Devereux Emmett. On May 17, 1899, the Garden City Golf Club was formed from the expanded course. Richard Howland Hunt designed the clubhouse. In 1902, Lori Ochterlony won the United States Open at Garden City Golf Club. It was the first time a player had shot under 80 in each of the four rounds. The tournament was won by amateur Walter Travis, a founding member of the Garden City Golf Club. Number 9. Winged Foot Golf Club, East. The construction of the golf courses must have generated quite a fuss at the time. Winged Foot had gone out of his way to find the best. The courses were designed by A.W. Tillinghast, one of the most well-known golf architects of the time. A.W. Tillinghast, who also designed Balthus Rahl, Lower, Bethpage Black, Suburban Golf Club, Shack Camax and Country Club, San Francisco Golf Club, Cedar Crest Park, and the adjoining Quaker Ridge Golf Club, Scarborough Golf and Country Club in Toronto, and Waikigal Country Club, was the course architect. The Winged Foot Golf Club was created in 1921 by a group of members primarily from the New York Athletic Club. The club's name and emblem are based on the NIACS, but the two organizations have never had a formal relationship. The Winged Foot Golf Club first opened its doors in June of 1923. Number 8. Bethpage State Park, Black. The sprawling Bethpage Black Golf Course, which was constructed in the mid-1930s to be the public Pine Valley, became the USGA's darling in the early 2000s when it hosted the 2002 and 2009 US Opens. Then, as site of the 2011 and 2016 Barclays, it became a PGA Tour darling. The PGA of America has now welcomed the Black, which will host the 2024 Ryder Cup and the 2019 PGA Championship. That's impressive for a course that used to be a rundown state park where you had to overnight in the parking lot to get a tee time. Number 7. Sabonac Golf Club. Since Augusta National, the country's best golfer has collaborated on a design project with one of the most highly respected course architects. However, the partnership between Jack Nicklaus and Tom Doak at Sabonac was hampered by the fact that golfer Nicklaus was also a renowned course architect, and the project was located next to two American landmarks, Shinnecock Hills and National Golf Links. Some commentators have compared Sabonac to Tom's bunkers, Jack's greens, yet this is far from the case. Doak persuaded Nicklaus to choose small greens with sweeping shapes and minor flaws that Jack would never have considered on his own. Meanwhile, Jack suggested that Tom soften his customary rough, jagged bunker expressions in order to appeal to the club's high handicap members. The 2013 U.S. Women's Open was held in Sabonac, and it was a huge success. Number 6. Oak Hill Country Club, East. Oak Hill Country Club, East, is ranked number 6. Donald Ross aficionados slammed George Fazio and his nephew Tom in 1979 for eliminating a classic Ross par 4 on Oak Hill East and replacing it with two new holes, notably the bowl-shaped par 3 6th, which would later be the site of four aces in 2 hours during the 1989 U.S. Open second round. On another par 3, they added a pond and moved the green on the par 4 18th. The club commissioned golf architect Andrew Green to redesign those holes to more closely resemble Donald Ross' original design. The original Ross hole has now been re-established by Green. pictured above. The East course was reconstructed following the 2019 Senior PGA Championship and was completed in May 2020. Number 5. Friar's Head Golf Club. Friar's Head is a short distance from Shinnecock Hills in Riverhead, New York. This challenging course, set on 350 acres, was designed by Bill Kerr and Ben Crenshaw and opened for play in 2003 with the notion that golf should be about possibilities and inventiveness at Friar's Head. Friar's Head passes through steep, wooded dunes and former farmland on its way to the sea. The course begins in the sand dunes, then moves to an old potato farm for holes 2-7 and 11-13, before returning to the sand hills for the remaining holes. The greens are massive, ranging in size from 3,000 to 18,000 square feet. Many bunkers are bearded and massive, while others are long strips that are simply massive. There are 200-foot cliffs overlooking Long Island Sound to the north of the property. The famous 15th hole is 460 yards long and is a par 4. The tee shot from an elevated tee must miss a huge bunker that collects shots as the fairway slopes from right to left. The approach shot is then played to a green that is slightly shielded from the sound breezes by trees in the back. Number 4. Winged CC Golf Club, West. The West and the East, both designed by A.W. Tillinghast, are two 18-hole golf courses at Winged Foot. The West course is a par 72 course with a distance of 7,477 yards, 6,837 meters, and a slope of 140. It has a course rating of 76.4 and a slope of 140. The East course is a par 72 course with a distance of 6,750 yards, 6,172 meters, and a slope of 140. It has a course rating of 73.6 and a slope of 140. In its 2009-10 list of America's 100 Greatest Golf Courses, Golf Digest placed the West course 8th and the East course 65th. Winged Foot was added to the National Register of Historic Places in 2019 as Tillinghast's final course to include a Clifford Charles Wendy Hack Clubhouse. When Claude Harmon, Sr. won the 1948 Masters and received a payment for $2,500, he was the head professional at Winged Foot GC. He was the most recent club professional to win a major title. Craig Wood, the head professional at Winged Foot, had previously won both the Masters and the U.S. Open in 1941. Making him the first golfer to do so in the same year. Number 3. Fisher's Island Club. Seth Rayner, the architect who designed the course, died in early 1926, before it was formally opened. His steeply banked bunkers and geometric greens blend in perfectly with the Atlantic Ocean and Long Island Sound's linear views. The holes are likewise of exceptional quality, with all of Rayner's regular suspects, including not one but two red and greens, one of which is on a par 4. Number 2. National Golf Links of America. Seth Rayner got his start as a golf architect here. He was a civil engineer by training, and he surveyed courses for architect C.B. MacDonald, who created National Golf Links as a scientific fusion of his favorite characteristics from magnificent old British golf holes. National Golf Links is a classic links course with a fantastic array of holes. MacDonald's versions are really superior in strategy than the originals, as the 2013 Walker Cup reminded us, which is why National's design is still studied by golf architects today, and its holes have been reproduced worldwide. It's hard to believe that from 1969 to 1985, National Golf Links of America was not included in the top 100 golf courses in the world. The par 4 14th hole is the most notable of the other holes, which were all designed by the club. The green was given the name Cape because it was situated on a short peninsula that jutted into a bay. The green was later relocated during the construction of Sabonac Inlet Road, although it is now encircled by a massive bunker on three sides. A windmill positioned between the 2nd and 16th holes is a unique feature on the golf course. When a member suggested that a windmill would be a great addition to the course, MacDonald bought one while in Europe and mailed the cost to the member. Number 1. Shinnecock Hills Golf Club. Shinnecock Hills Golf Club is an old club with old traditions, and Scottish professional Willie Davis, with the help of 150 Indians from the nearby Shinnecock Reservation, can lay claim to the first authentically designed U.S. golf course, which dates back to 1891 when Davis laid out the first 12 holes. By 1894, head professional Willie Dunn had added six more holes. Shinnecock Hills Golf Club was not only one of the five original members of the USGA, but it also had one of the first purpose-built golf clubhouses. Stanford White constructed the clubhouse in the region's shingled style, and it sits majestically on the property's highest point. The first tee box is just a few feet away from the white-columned building, from which you can see Peconic Bay glistening in the distance and, in the foreground, the open, sprawling 300-acre golf course that tumbles away from the clubhouse. What do you think about this video? Do let us know down in the comments section below. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from us again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go.